Many now say the government will use Abe's death to highlight the need for the kind of security policies he championed. His one disappointment was his failure to gain support in reversing the pacifist constitution of Japan and nudge Japan towards some level of independence from the United States. This was all a legacy, of course, of World War II, when Japan was caught up in World War II, as you know, and then the constitution made, embedded in the constitution, was the failure. Japan not allowed, really, to entertain international engagement. So it should be said, though, in seeking to revise the constitution, Abe did anger China and South Korea, who were two victims of Japan's 20th century militarism.